Like, hey, like, that's a good Foley art, man. He's jumping that in right in there. Damn, okay. I'm ready.
Fresh out of high school, joined the Marine Corps at 18 years old. It was the absolute best thing I could possibly do. And I thank my dad for that because my dad gave me two options. You know, join the Marine Corps. Actually, that was the only option. Join the Marine Corps. That was actually the only option. So I joined the Marine Corps, so that was cool. I got out and actually didn't even realize that what I've gone through in the Marine Corps in those 4 years would actually really help me in my everyday life. And I'm not only speaking about mentally, but also physically. I'm talking about even to like a standard of the way I live. A lot of people are pushed because they don't have the time, because they're pushed to do something on someone else's time to create a living. A lot of people ask me every day, what do you do for a living? And I honestly get to answer, live life and help you. Which is amazing to think about, because a lot of people wake up or they get this notion that, oh, I want to need a little bit more time in bed. And then I thought about that for a second. I was like, wow, everybody sleeps under the covers and they always feel so comfortable. And then I was like, wow, that's what the balance grew is. It's being getting comfortable with being uncomfortable. I sleep on top of my blankets. How amazing is that? People are like, hey, are you ready for something? I must be ready. If I sleep on top of my blankets, I must be ready. You know, so for me, I guess it wasn't the complacency. In the Marine Corps, I had a staff sergeant that he just said, there's no retreat, no surrender. There was no option for me not to get the task done. In the Marine Corps, we learned about mission accomplishment versus troop welfare, which means that a lot of people rather eat before they take care of their body. And for me, it was take care of my body and then you could eat. Saying Travis versus the Balance Guru. The Balance Guru, as you know, we talked about earlier, is the online persona that allows me to be able to reach and speak. Most people, they see things all the time, but to get someone to actually sit and concentrate on you, it takes some difference. It takes a specific niche. Mm-hmm. So Travis Horn is the emotion behind the Balance Guru.
Right.
Without Travis Horn, there is no Balance Guru, vice versa. So it's the emotion that I take from my everyday life, and I put it behind the brand of the Balance Guru. In reality, balance is a community of everyone. The Balance Guru is just the leader. That's how I kind of look at it, as if I'm going to go ahead and show something or give something to the world, like, you know, whoever invented the car, I must be held accountable to myself to actually go and teach. And that's where the Balance Guru comes from compared to the Travis Horn. I'm raw, I have emotion, I wear my heart on my sleeve. I'm a humanitarian person. The Balance Guru doesn't show that. The Balance Guru just shows work ethic, hardcore, consistency, dedication, motivation. So that's what allows me to piggyback on the Travis Horn Balance Guru situation, for sure. I got out of the Marine Corps, and the Travis Horn inside of me had a lot of raw emotions and feelings that I just could not speak, or didn't have any direct therapy or direct contact with people who I needed help a certain way. Everyone out there needs help. They just need it the way they need it, not necessarily the way people are giving it. So I had to actually take a step back and say, I'm going to eliminate everything, and I'm going to be different. Being different is what created that. My motivation was to be different. My motivation was to take something and to bring it from an emotional form to a physical form. I mentally had to get prepared to transition into the physical form, because a lot of people have something to explain and say, and there's not a lot of therapists and teachers to actually listen. So what I had to do was I had to take my raw emotions and break it down to a physical form where someone could be like, wow, he's actually got something really deep that he needs to explain. So now I'm able to explain it from my consistency in becoming the Balance Guru. Yeah, I guess my personal issues with Travis Horn was my family and my friends. You know, they didn't really understand the direction or the consistency that I had to put into a persona or online brand to be able to help my friends and my family in the future. It was very tough. Like my sister, you know, she always wanted to know, like, why do I have to tell my story? Or, you know, or my brother says, why do you have to do things for free? Or my dad says, yo, the next time you're going to kill yourself. Like, so I had to, that personally from the Travis side, I had to, I don't know. I'm still battling that till this day, I guess, with this persona of my personal versus the Balance Guru side. So yeah, that's something that I'm having to deal with, the emotional side. The Balance Guru, I understand that I'm a teacher, I'm a helper, and I have the consistency inside of my brand. So that's why now I have to try to piece together to show that, hey, I did this not to hurt anyone, but to help everyone. And it had to be like that. Sometimes you have to go and step back, and some people just might not understand exactly why.
Scusami, ma voglio sapere, tanto così si rilassa un po', ma ti sono passate le vertigini, la paura, o hai ancora paura?
Yes, I'm still afraid of highness.
Lo immagino.
Sì, ho ancora paura delle vertigini.
Ok, Travis.
You ready?
Okay.
Okay.
3, 2, 1, go.
Che record!
È stato incredibile!
Come here, please, come here, please. Ok!
Congratulations! A new Guinness World Records title!
Guinness World Records! Thank you so much! Great job!
Everyone has different forms of support. You know, growing up, you know, some people might have the breakfast, lunch, and dinner, 3 meals a day, you know, and some people might have the struggle and they have to go to churches and, you know, they might need certain charities to help them out. The way I grew up is all perspective-wise, and the time that it was just a little tougher than what I've seen or what I've seen around me from what people have developed. And through that, it actually gave me the push to understand that I strive off of not being perfect. I actually strive off the drive and the journey. I'm not one of the people that gives me words of affirmation. If you tell me that I'm a beast, that doesn't really do anything. So you have to really learn on how you soar and evaluate yourself to keep growing. And that's honestly, if I think back now how my childhood was, all it was a motivation to not live like that, to not have my child experience that, and to understand that we're going into a life where we can create at a massive scale. So I wanted to be included in that. So my childhood just made me have a lot of accountability, because I didn't have necessarily a direct religion to keep me responsible at that time, direct parents to keep me responsible at that time. So I had to have a lot of self-accountability. And the one thing I learned about from my childhood from my father, which was do the right thing when no one's looking. As in, he came in and he told us that if you don't do this, you're only going to fail yourself. And that like stuck to me. Like, so if I told myself that I needed to do this, if I didn't do it, I was the only one that was going to take the hit. And that to me is very, very important when it came to my childhood and developing into as a man and into the Marine Corps, into now the Balance Guru. Is the Marine Corps taught me also do the right thing when no one's looking. So that just kind of self-accountability kind of allowed me to get over the experiences through my injuries. Like, I mean, I had a knee replacement, ACL reconstructive surgery in the Marine Corps. So when I got out, I actually had to develop myself without therapy. So that's when I first started thinking that I need to become a therapist. I 2 years later after the Marine Corps, I broke my femur. I got hit by a jet ski in Orlando and I broke my femur. Again, I have a rod, 4 screws. I didn't have direct therapy, so I had to become a therapist. So instead of having the notion that I needed to talk to someone or there was a therapist, if you don't have the money, you have to have accountability for yourself. So if you have pain and you have no one to talk to, that's what the Balance Guru came into play. Like, listen, I've gone through these injuries and now I'm going to study the body to allow myself to help you and teach you about the body. And that's the experiences were absolutely so needed, and it had to happen this way. And I'm pretty sure if you think about it in your life, everything had to happen for you to be standing right here. So the story is powerful, twice as powerful as the moves. I'm the 6 of diamonds in the universe, which means I'm the truth card. You know, so I'm like the Liar Liar movie. I have a red pen. I can't write blue. And honestly, it actually gets really, it's got me this far, and I don't have to backtrack. I think that's very important when you don't have to backtrack your story. If you're always being honest, then the story stays the same. So, and I believe that I'm a huge reason for accountability in the fitness and the health community right now, especially on the internet, especially right now on Instagram. I make people held accountable. That means if you say you're a teacher and you're a helper, I hold you accountable. I write you and have a 100% track record of being consistent and being honest and writing people back. So I think that is a huge advantage, that I have the time, energy, and effort and motivation to help people honestly. Because, I mean, of course, I could have developed 19 books, 19 workouts already, 17 diet plans, but I have not done the world like that. And you know that, Tony. I've spent 8 years learning to create one body manual that has absolutely everything in it, so you don't need anything else. That's why I say I just saved you thousands of dollars on health insurance, and you didn't switch to Geico, you switched to Guru. I created that because of that situation of all I thought was is you don't need the gym plan, the supplement plan, the workout plan, the mental motivation plan, the stretch plan. You need one plan. And if all of our bodies is blood, sweat, and tears, there is one plan. That's what I say. It's kind of like, you know, Jesus left us the Bible, and I'll leave the earth with the body manual. The body manual, I sat there and thought of the most simplest form, from elder to toddler, from any injury, if you're blind, if you're paralyzed, if you have any kind of disability, which obviously you know I got disabilities. I have a broken arm right now, two-torn rotator cuffs, scoliosis, sciatica, tendonitis, ACL reconstructive surgery, broken femur, rolled ankle, PTSD, anxiety, depression. I have all of that stuff, but the excuses I don't allow run my life. And that's why I created the body manual. So it does not matter what issues you have. It's right there. It's the simplest form. The Marine Corps, they taught me how to break it down Barney style. I'm a communicator, right? Barney style. I can communicate with you. Yeah, Barney style, which means that you can read it and you can take it and you can do it. Even you. That's important. It's important. What if you don't know the language? Imagine, even the person that doesn't know the language can take the body manual and look at it, and it's simple. Remember, I'm a therapist. I didn't break it down to, you know, like, flexion of the arm. I didn't break it down to nothing like that, because I believe there's a lot of people out there that are taking advantage of the lingo, you know, like, so it's, I don't want to take advantage of the lingo. You have a dictionary, you know it as a basic form, and that's how people will learn. And unfortunately, that's how people are learning. If I broke it down completely into a doctor form, it would just be too much. And I want to connect you guys. I want to connect. That's what they don't understand. Tony, you know, I'm an underdog. We didn't have anything. So I'm here for the little man. I'm here for the underdogs, the ones that don't have money for therapists, the ones that don't have money to get a personal trainer, the ones that don't have anybody to speak to. There's no businesses, organizations, brands that want to support them. That's why I'm here, and that's why I'm going to make it, Tony, just because of that. I think at first when I was, you know, I was banging out in the gyms and no one cared, I think it was, I got a lot of, are you in CERC? I got a lot of, are you in CERC? So to be honest, the CERC people are the only ones that should feel any sign of certain way about me, because I really took what they've been doing, CERC people and stuff like that, that have been training since toddler age, and I got out of the Marine Corps and I jumped in, and if people automatically already thought I was in CERC and I didn't have any professional training, no coaching or anything like that, they're the only ones that should feel a certain type of way of me, like, exposing the extreme wild training. And then I got approached with someone that was like, you know, you're an artist. What you do is art. And I didn't even think about it like that, because, you know, I was just, you know, just doing everyday life. So, yeah, me as an extreme artist, it's now I think people are understanding the health side of this, because I'm getting to do stuff like this and podcasts and I'm training professional athletes. But at first, even my family, they did not understand. Even me, to be honest, I didn't grow up I'm going to be the balance guru. No. This was just something that I understood, like, to a T, to the molecular cellular level. And it just so happens that I enjoyed it. I went through massage school and I got 4.0. I straight aced it. You know, I got a C average in college, but I aced massage therapy school because it was about the body. So I think now they'll take it serious. And that's because I think health and wellness and balance, the word balance is everywhere. And I mean, you know as well as I know, if you can show someone that was putting on balance like this, original, everyday consistency before I was, like I said, I'll take some lessons. But yeah, man, when we were children, man, we wish our parents would get down the way I get down with my son. And like, and that's what it has to do with. It has to do with we live in a different era and age where we have accessibility to do things that our children and kids would like. And my son is... I'm a role model to him already, as in, like, we were doing this thing and they were like, had four options, and my dad was like, oh, you're already one of those, and one of the options was superhero. And if my son already at 8 years old thinks I'm a superhero, what he's gonna understand is, remember, think about us, we went to middle school and high school and we didn't get any direct backing from our father as a man. Like, our parents didn't go to our basketball game or our football game. Like, my son's going to have the ability in middle school and high school. There's going to be kids walking up to my son saying, no, your dad is a savage. Your dad is, my dad watches your dad. Or, you know, like, my dad says, so that right there is so much direct motivation just for my son being able to experience that, what we didn't get to experience. And, of course, if I want to be a great father, I couldn't let a job, or I couldn't let schooling, or I couldn't let anything hinder from that. So what would you do if you didn't have a job and you stayed home with your kid and you wanted to express something to the world? You took him with you. So my son can handstand, you know, he's traveled with me to places to already do things. Like, I mean, he's right now jingling keys right now. Like, you know, he's jingling keys right now. Like, you know, so he's there. He's making sure that he's there because, you know, the keys are in his pocket and he's moving. So, yeah, no, my son is directly involved with me. And I have tons of viral videos that when he looks older, he's already in so many videos, you know. So I don't know. The drive is for him to just understand that he's loved and cared for and he gets to experience everything that I didn't get to experience. It's important for me. Yeah, that's a big thing, man. I haven't even got to get started yet, man. That's so messed up. I've been doing this for 8 years. I haven't even got to get started yet. Wow.
So
it's dangerous. Imagine, they don't want to unleash me. That's why the collaborations haven't happened yet, because if someone puts me on a platform that has millions of followers, I'm just getting to where they don't want me to get, because then that's dangerous. You know, if you're LeBron James, you're not going to invite Kobe Bryant to the birthday party. It just don't happen. Like, you don't want to be outshined. And what happened was, is they didn't even know I was out there to outshine them eventually. They didn't know that I was going to be the one to take over like Conor McGregor in the MMA. You can look at Conor McGregor's story and he was like, I'm going to run the MMA. It took him less than 2 years and he was running the MMA. Right. So for me, it's like, I've been working so hard to take over and run the new age of fitness. So, like, yeah, the NBA players that are in right now and stuff like that, they already have trainers. They already have the things going on. I have the demographic that is 18 to 30, 24, that I will command those people when it comes to health and wellness and fitness. And that's where the respect level started coming from that question. It took a while. It took 8 years to show them that I'm not here to play games.
Would you say you're like the Kanye West of wellness and fitness?
It's deep, man. It's so deep. Like, it's hard to explain. Like, I should have already been on sports science. They should have already plugged me up to electrodes. They should have already been trying to further, because I believe that I'm here to further what we've done as mankind already, not go backwards. So if I've jumped on a ball on 10 stacks of dumbbells, I believe that someone should be doing 11. If not, someone should be training to do it. Man, my goal in life, Tony, is to just teach people the neutral. It's to get people to understand that there is a homeostasis in your body when it's mentally and physically, whether it's mentally or physically, you have to understand there is a homeostasis. The body is one big tensegrity model. You have to understand it's connected as a whole. So I want people to slow down a little bit, you know, get the electronics and all this stuff that everyone's so fast and they're going on and on and on. We just need to slow down for a second and understand the neutral and understand that gravity is the only thing that's putting pressure, negative and positive, on your life every single day. So I come to you to teach people about the science of the body from my own